Just put. Come on in. Come on, you're still wet. Come on. Good girl. Sit. Hello, puppy dog. Hello, puppy dog.
So we're going to be keeping her nice and calm today because poor little pup's got epilepsy, bless her. And she had two seizures yesterday. And so, well, last night, actually, whilst myself and the old man were at the cinema. Luckily, mum was here. But yeah, we've got to keep her nice and calm today. Haven't we, Jessie Pup? Good girl. Anyway, what's up guys? Liam here and welcome back to LSJTV. Today we're gonna jump right in. We're wearing some straps just because, you know, feeling a bit tender today. And so, better be safe than sorry, you know? I wanna start off by saying thank you for your support and thank you for all of your advice on basically, sorry I'm out of breath, on what we should do. You know, obviously I'm in a nice kind of situation right now, as I explained in the last video or the one before that, I don't know, I kind of lose track now, but anyway. Thank you for your support on that, and thank you for everybody's kind of feedback, you know, because it really does help. If I can get a broad perspective of what everybody thinks, combined with what I think, my family and Charlotte and everything, it really does help, so thank you. Starting off with a pool day today. Pool day, we've done some lat pull down just to get the lats firing. We're onto some deadlifts. We're gonna do some more pull downs. We're gonna do some rows. It's gonna be good, it's gonna be sick. You already know that, don't you? Yes, you do. My beautiful people, thank you for tuning in today. If you are excited, please drop the video a like. Let's do some more deadlifts. Let's get it going. 165 pounds, 150 kg deadlift, 2 reps, let's go. Yes. Slowly but surely building that up, guys. Single reps, double reps, sets of eight. But it's difficult, you know? Deficit. We're in a deficit. Did you know? I'm in a deficit. One thing with that, though, guys, is that right now, I'm in a very, I feel like, maintainable position. I'm only what, like 15%, 14% body fat. I'm under no illusion that I'm shredded. I'm just a lot better than I was kind of, you know, a few months ago. And basically, I feel like I'm in a very maintain, I just feel like I need to clarify that purely because of what people have been saying. And thank you for your suggestions and everything, but I think some people have got the illusion that I now think I'm shredded and I'm ready to bulk again. That's not the case, so I just needed to justify that, you know? But anyway, I feel like I'm in a very maintainable position right now at this body fat percentage. You know, I haven't really, my diet hasn't been great since I've hit 165 pounds. It's probably been the worst it's been for a while, actually. And it hasn't really gone anywhere. I've just stuck to my cardio, stuck to my training like I normally have. And don't get me wrong, I do my cardio, and when I do my cardio, I work hard. When I train, I work hard. It might not seem it on here all the time, but I do. And so, it's a very maintainable position for me, and I feel like I can almost progress a little bit more with my lifts whilst in this kind of maintenance slash low deficit, very low deficit kind of position. But hey, we shall see. Let's up the deadlift, shall we? Ooh. a terrible PB. But I've never pulled 170 before. I've only really deadlifted for one rep a few times in my life. So 170 at 165 pounds after only deadlifting for about 6 weeks. On and off. You see what I'm saying? I feel like we can do this, you know? Lol, I've just watched that back and I'm like... Anyway, you get the point though. I've actually managed to pull that amount of weight. Long story short, what happened there was I just forgot about my legs and started pulling with like my lower back and stuff. Because I've not been doing it for that long, but I'm also pushing for these numbers. It's just not necessary. I just need to slow the numbers down, you know, and just keep progressing with the motor pathways, you know? Building them, strong. See, the thing is, I've got that with bench, with shoulder press, with squats. I've got all of those because I've been doing them for like 3 years. Deadlift, I've been doing for like 3 weeks in comparison, you know? But still, I'll take that. There's gonna be people watching this thinking, oh my God, 170 kilos, what? But you know, that's big for me. You can only compare yourself to yourself. And as soon as you get other people out of your head, other people's numbers, other people's weight, other people's shreddedness out of your head, focus on yourself, that's when you'll become much more happier, much more successful, if you like, because, you know, you'll feel better within yourself. And that is success, if you ask me. If you are satisfied with the progress that you are making, f*** everyone else. Because what does it matter? Nothing. What matters is what you see right here. What you see in the mirror and how you feel is the most important thing. You are your own competition. You can only compare yourself to the person that you were yesterday. Have you done something good today that's improved the person you were yesterday? Have you lost a bit of weight today that's improved the person you were yesterday? Have you put on a bit more strength or size, if that's your goal, to improve the person that you were yesterday? Stop comparing yourself to these people on freaking social media that are just not real, not attainable physiques. They're just, half of them are on gear and they're not telling you. One thing you have to understand about the whole fitness industry is that people's livelihoods depend on how they look. Literally, these people are fitness models. These people are athletes for companies. These people are professionals in what they do. Their livelihood depends on, in a lot of cases, the way they look. And so they're not telling you the entire truth about what they're taking, what they're doing, how they're training. They're just saying, buy my plan and you'll look like me, which is just not the freaking case. Stop comparing yourself to everybody else in the industry and look at yourself in the freaking mirror and think, what can I do to make myself just that little bit better than I was yesterday? Because let me tell you, people, all of those little teeny tiny irrelevant things that people think mean nothing and are pointless, they all add up. They all add up eventually into something freaking big. Focus on you, people. Do what you gotta do for you. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a very good dilemma on my hands. You know, things changed with this whole my protein situation. It made me feel like I would again have to look a certain way to kind of fit the part. But then, some very wise comments and some wise words from my friends and family made me realize that actually, I got into that position looking the way that I look. I didn't look like these unreal kind of fitness people, you know? I mean, you can tell I go to the gym, you know, but I don't look like, you know, I'm no freaking Steve Cook or anyone like that, you know? So, I think I've made my decision and I'm gonna write myself a little plan out the next 4 weeks, and we're going to follow that to a T. We're going to see how it goes. But the thing was, people want me to bulk, you know. People want to see that 100 kg OHP. People want to see me put on size so that I can then get shredded and compete, because, you know, you guys want to see me compete as soon as possible, right? And I understand that. I want to compete as soon as possible. But I just feel like it's just not quite the right time. Just not quite the right time for me to bulk yet. Because we're still making progress exactly how we are. So if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So, session done, and I'm sure a lot of you will have already figured out that we are going to keep going with the diet. I call it a diet, hang on. I call it a diet, but I don't feel like I've been dieting because it's been so simple, easy, sustainable, all the words that I keep throwing at you in every single video, right? I don't feel like I'm at the end of a, oh my God, I need a pizza. Oh my God, I need, because I've had it as I've gone along, but I've just taken my time with it and lost weight. Because all you need is a consistent calorie deficit, and that's what I've had for the past kind of 4 or 5 months. You know, I've just slowly but surely lost some weight, got in better shape, improved my lifts, it's been great. And that hasn't stopped yet, and so I'm not gonna stop that. That's my decision, I've made it, I've done it, I'm sticking to it, gonna lose a bit more. How much more, I don't know. That part I've not figured out yet. I'll figure it out when I write the plan. But that is it. Let me know your thoughts, people. This is gonna be controversial. This is gonna piss some people off. I'm sorry I'm not bulking just yet. I'm sorry I'm also not getting shredded just yet. We're not doing either, okay? We're just gonna keep going as we are because it got us into a pretty good position. And I have faith in myself that I can achieve all of the stuff I want to achieve in the long run. I know I can. We got this, people. We got this. All in good time. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you so much for your messages. Thank you so much for your suggestions on what the friggin' hell to do. It really has, in the long run, helped clear my head. Because, you know, I was scrambled to start off with. And to be honest, I'm still not too sure. But I've said it now. That's what we're going to do. Okay, so thank you everybody. Thank you so much for your support again. I know I've just said that, but my protein links on the note of the whole confusion. My protein links in the description as always. Code LSJ. Use the link and the code. Send me the screenshots. I'll enter you into next month's competition giveaway. Once more, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Subscribe if you are new. Like the video. Comment, share, all that good jazz. All that YouTube stuff. Really helps us. Thank you very much. Together, we will grow. And I will see you in the next one.